What's up, YouTube? So like me, you guys probably jumped on the Electra Jailbreak right as it came out, and everything seemed really good, installed everything you wanted, went to bed last night. You woke up this morning, and you had a few updates, which is cool. We're used to updates in the jailbreak scene. You did the updates, and one of them was this APT7, and now your Cydia doesn't work. Well, you're not alone. This happened to quite a few users, including myself. I was actually laying in bed, and then all of a sudden, bam, my phone was, I was looking, I'm like, what happened here? Anyways, we all know what's going on here. APT07 was updated by Shernix, and the reason he updated it was for the 10.33 jailbreak. He didn't test it with Electra, and unfortunately, because the build number was higher, all the Electra devices grabbed it from his repo instead of Coolstar's repo, and then we had a broken Cydia. Now Coolstar has actually updated and pushed a fix for this since I wasn't able to push my fix for it this morning, and there was a lot of people on Reddit who posted too, but a lot of you guys said, hey, I don't know how to do this. So I want to show you guys how to do this. The first thing I want everybody to try, because it's the easiest method, is to head here, download the Electra 1.0.2, delete Electra on your device, and reinstall it. So delete it and then reinstall it. I've already installed the latest version. If you want to know if you're running the latest version, just open the application. Now you guys see my Cydia is all broken. So I'm going to reboot my device here. I need to pause the video because my screen capture software will freak out if the device loses connection. And I'll come back. We're going to re-jailbreak and I'll show you guys that this does work. And then I'm going to show you guys the manual method to do this, the method that I used this morning to do this that worked for me, since a lot of you guys are still having issues. So, hey, let's do it. All right, so my device is rebooted here. As you can see, I'm not jailbroken. Make sure you have the 11 or the 1.0.2 version, and we just hit the install and wait. All right, so now we've rebooted our device. Let's open Cydia and see what happens. I'm getting a one here. Yep. So it looks like the latest version of Electra fixed my device. Now this message is okay. This means that you've updated to the latest Electra, and Shernix's repo has now been blocked, so this never happens again. Now you're probably sitting there saying, hey, I did this and it didn't work. I got you. So what happens if you did this and it doesn't work? Let's download an application called CyberDuck. Now this is going to work for Windows and Mac. Download and install the application, just like I have here. Now we do need the IP, the local IP of the device we need to do this. So mine is 11.11.0.18. I'm going to go to open a connection and choose the SFTP. Now for server, you just want to put in your IP address. The username is root, and depending on your configuration, the default password is Alpine. If you've never changed your password, it's Alpine, A-L-P-I-N-E. Connect. Now you want to head to this drop-down menu and go to the /. Now you can see in my root directory, I have two files here. We need to go to this tutorial and download this one file. Now here you can see that I have two. The one that we want to focus on says Coolstar. This is the file that will fix your device. Now before I can fix my device, I need to break it. So I'm going to show you guys in real time. I'm going to break Cydia and then I'm going to fix it. So here we go, Cydia works. Oops. You guys don't have to follow along with this part. I'm just breaking my Cydia. So you guys can now see I am now suffering from the same issue that you guys are, from installing the wrong package. So there's nothing, I can't really do anything. No packages show up. You can fix this without actually rebooting if you use this method. So let's start from the beginning. So you're going to take this file that you've downloaded from this tutorial that I've included a link in the description, and you're going to drag it to your root directory and file doc. Make sure this window is large enough that you can drag the file into this area and not drop it into some folder somewhere. So you don't want to do that. Mine's going to ask if I want to overwrite. Yours will just write. Make sure your upload is complete and successful before you begin. Now you will need to open up Terminal. And you can do this by going up to the hourglass in your bar and searching for Terminal. You can hit Command Space, or you'll be able to find it just here in your launchpad. Now you'll want to type in SSH space root @11. Now this is your device's IP, so your device's IP will probably be like 190. Oh, what is the default one? 197 or 198.0.0. So put in your device's IP. And type in your device's root password. Now here, we drop this into the root directory. So we want to go to this /folder. So we're going to type in cd and then /. Enter. Now let's verify that we're in CD, although you will see instead of the home directory, you're now at the root directory, but you can also type in ls, enter, and you will see the file labeled CoolStar that we need to fix our device. Now you want to type in dpkg -i and then copy over this deb all the way to the .deb. Make sure you get that there, and then paste. Your command should look like this. Hit enter. Don't worry about this warning. Now on your device, you'll want to close Cydia. Make sure you force close it. Open Cydia. And now everything works as it should. And just to show you guys, I will even install the updated SSH, which I've been just lazy and haven't done. There you go, Cydia works. I really, really hope that this fixes your issue, guys. This is how I fixed my device very early morning. I do recommend using the updated Electra, just because, hey, it's an updated version to the Jailbreak. It fixes a few other things besides this issue. And I really truly hope that this fixes your device and that you guys are back on the Jailbreak and enjoying. If this video helped you, let me know in the comments below. I like to know some feedback and how things worked out for everybody. I chose to use CyberDuck because it is a free program, but you can use, like, I use Coda is my preference for SFTP connections. And like I said, this will also work on Windows. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you again next time. Cheers.